heart in. So it was very short duration. But in the beginning, I didn't get connected very much with SAT's program. But it was little bit delayed. And by the actually help of selfless service of many devotees, especially Vedanta Sutra Prabhu, Venkat Prabhu, and Mehmet Prabhu, Tarun Prabhu, they actually helped me a lot to bring me Krishna consciousness. Before coming to SAT's program, actually, while I did my BTech in Kolkata, Bengal Engineering College, so there was one ISKCON center, so I was going there, and but I was not at all serious there, and just I used to go because they used to invite and request a lot. Few times I went there, but it didn't actually, of course, prasadam always gives that mercy. It takes time to manifest everything. Then I get connected here in SAS program. But I had lots of actually impersonal philosophy in my mind. So that's happened actually in our part of country. So there are many impersonal philosophers and impersonal theories are going on. And that is probably one of the major reasons that many people could not join in Krishna consciousness. So, but when I joined here in the beginning, and parallelly I was practicing other impersonal philosophies also. So I don't want to take their names. Many organizations are there. So, but of course, by the help of prasadam, by the help of especially Hare Krishna Mahamantra, and Sharon Mataji's so much facility they have been provided for us, that really within very short time it helped me to come out from that situation. And slowly I started chanting. One event I remember, like in 2012 December, there was one japa retreat. Like Mayam Prabhu was saying that these retreats are very important for us. And in the beginning I was not interested to go because it was long 1 week program, and I was very much soaked in my academic career and improving that. But Vedanta Sutra Prabhu requested me that you go at least one day, and he begged me, literally he begged me that please go. And his lab is just above my one floor, just above my lab, so he would come sometimes. And finally I decided that I will go for 1 day or 2 days. So I went there, and it was an amazing experience. Like in the retreat we have seen that only the IITK devotees and some Gurukul boys, except that all are actually Western devotees. That is what I have seen. And by seeing that all the people gathered from different part of world, actually that it immediately increases that intention that what is there here. Till that time I think that some sentimental things and some things are going on. but that provoked me that you should go deeper. Maybe something is there I am missing. So then I, in that retreat, I started chanting more deeply and try to hear what Sari is teaching us, and started reading Bhagavad Gita. And then whatever impersonal theories I was listening, and I was going there, finally I understood that actually they are also trying to speak from the scripture. And here also we are trying to speak from scripture. But the difference is that they are speaking, they have deviation from the scripture, and they speak partly from the scripture, and they add their own mental concoction. And here the Srila Prabhupada's scripture is Bhagavad Gita as it is. So that helped me that I should let other things go. Let me follow Bhagavad Gita as it is. So why to follow like others' own mental concoction? So like that way I started, and it was very short time. By the time I became a little bit serious, my time is over here. So then by the mercy of all the devotees, and especially Sharan Mataji, So when I went for my PhD in Singapore, fortunately I went there in the devotee camp, devotee base. I don't know if I would not go there, what would happen. Means I was not very serious when I was leaving the IIT ke Sambal. So, but fortunately I was put into that that camp, and Vidyanand Prabhu was there, and especially that place helped me a lot. Because full time I was staying there and all the practices we had to do, and especially Vidyanand Prabhu was helping on the Sunday morning, like 3 a.m. you get up and everyone will take bath, and morning we have to do Mangal Arati. Like Prabhuji would do the morning Arati, and others will chant and sing all the practices we had to do. And soon after, there is another devotee, many of you may be knowing, Amogvira Prabhu. He also did the master's from here. So fortunately, I am associating with him a little bit more. And he was very strict about practice. Every single day, he would get up a little before 4 a.m. And within 10 minutes, 15 minutes, he will be ready. And just 16 full rounds, he will chant in one shot by in fixed sitting posture. And somehow or other, he caught me. I was little bit surrendering to him, and he caught me, and he also pushed me to do that. And like that way, 2 years spent very nicely. And after that, again, I had to move under some circumstances to Canada. But fortunately, like there was also temple, and I just stayed beside the temple. That is what I learned, that I should stay near the temple, and somehow or other, I have to get connected, otherwise everything will be lost. So there also I was connected, and like that way it is going on. So my PhD is over now. So SAT's instruction is that I should apply here and help in SAT's movement, whatever capacity I can do. So I seek all the assembled the blessings from all the assembled Vaishnavas, and especially from Sir and Mataji. Sir's father and mother are there, so I seek blessings from them so that I can discharge my instructions without deviation. So that will be my success in my life. Thank you very much.
Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol.
Prabhuji, can I add one thing? Today, Prabhuji was making the dough. He was kneading the dough in the kitchen, and Mataji was holding the utensil. So I told him that Mataji is very nice. And you're very lucky to have a wife like her. So she said, Mataji, I am also very nice. Otherwise, in most of the temples I go to, and in my Delhi temple, if I tell somebody, oh, you are good, they say, no, I'm not good. So this is the first time I saw the actual
So, let the troll that I am also nice, eh? You are giving a lot of prominence to Anu, eh?
I think this is actually.
Okay. So, three times Hari Bol to Suvendu.
Hari Bol! Hari Bol! Hari Bol!
So, Tirupati Prabhu is sitting there, please come. You know, he was in Delhi and he invited me for a lunch. And I think Radhakant was over there. Sura was three of us. And then I told him and his wife, come to Vrindavan.
Then I did 3-4 diplomas, like practical oriented. Computer also. Computer and electronics. Also, and some IIT courses also I did. because of no satisfaction invite theory part in B. So I did all the courses because there I had seen good people and good technical people and nice people and more intelligence. My attraction also there. Okay, this way I got an opportunity, so I will finish it. So there I stayed up to 5-6 years. Then I born Odisha, studied there, married in Andhra Pradesh, and established in Delhi. So like
Sanjukta is Andhra Pradesh, she's in India.
Actually the family settled there.
Ah, she knows Odia. She speaks better Odia than us.
No better. Like South Odisha. So again, I think that there is so much money is there and transaction is there in North India. There I got two jobs in government sector. Initial government sector. Initially in 18 there I was lecturer up to 2 years in government of India. And still I had no satisfaction in my life because of lecturers. So again I had gone.
Please be silent.
Because of lectures, no use for me. Then I had so many diploma courses I want to use. Practically, I was interested towards any R&D, diploma, and designing courses. So I jumped to manufacturing lab, computer manufacturers. So there computers also like 1,90,000 that time. So I jumped to touch field. Experience is there, okay, I will go there. Then there I stuck, there up to 2-3 years, I had up to that field, the design field and manufacturing. Then again this, that time China and India, like this. So in the company also they jump over to service and maintenance. So after that I thought, okay, manufacturing line is going little bit competitive. It means they are going jump to maintenance and service field. I also jump over there. Then I jump over to service and maintenance field. Like use money is there, okay. And but parts also big costly. R&D I know. Design I know. Maintenance I know. Servicing I know. Okay. Then okay, then I jump over to that. Again, that line also continue up to 10 years, 5, 6, 10 years. Then I stayed up to 5, 6 years. Competitive field is there. Because of that side. So after that, I thought, if there's two competitors, so get and some good money, I came here. I started my business. Started my business and continue up to 6, 7, 8 years later. Again I fast, Compaq, IBM, all computers again came to me. There also I fight up to 7, 8 years. There also computers. there also, again income source also going very less. Luck is that again 70, 80, 70, 80. So also again expenditure also increasing. All the computer instruments, rent and all this employment. No. Okay, I will think about that. And again I talk to you. Again I will switch over to lecture line. That was the best time. I come over to any technical like diploma and technical students. There I go hard for like the night courses, etc. Let me get some experience so that I can continue there. If competition is there, okay, I will overcome that and my life will be successful. Then there also I had seen. Here competition is there, here competition is there. Again one more also I had. Actually I jump over to East of Kalas. That time. East of Kalas is in front of East of Kalas. There I had seen one more line also there. That is spiritual. Spiritual is that, lecture is that, competition is that. Then I continue up to 3-4 years. Okay, let me struggle. So, lastly, by this way, I got mercy. That time it was there to switch over to okay, anyway, I will get some rest. I will think about this spiritual life. Okay, let me get some chance. Okay, I am getting some chance. Here also, some side is also ready to study there. Okay, Mataji also getting. This will be best. Okay. And Masi is there. Then got opportunity also. That is also. So I switch over to Masi. Masi of Sar. Here I am doing some seva. Whatever the experience like this, so I will reflect my experience.
Yeah, his son was very sick, that is why Sandhukta didn't come, his wife. And Abhikita, kaisa hai, how is he doing? Better. That medicine is helping.
Not medicine, something like massage and yoga.
So, now he's doing that. Okay. So, you are happy in Gurukul or not? Or you are thinking another line will come?
Brilliant. I think just, you know, spending such quality time with a lot of devotees such as you. And this is the first time I'm meeting Leela Pushottam Prabhu. Like, I have been trying for, I think some time now, but somehow, the stars were not aligned. because I tried meeting him a couple of times when he was in the one for the good food project, but it just didn't happen. I think unlike all the devotees who spoke before me, they don't have such interesting stories to tell you. I think my association, of course, is a lot of credit for my ISKCON association, goes to Piyush Prabhu. Piyush Prabhu and I go way back. We did our college together in 2002 to 2005. So we know each other for 16 years and know each other fairly closely. Of course, we were in touch with each other for a good long time in between because, of our corporate jobs, so to say. I think God, Krishna has his own ways of attracting you towards himself. And, whether it is by offering some obstacles in your life or, having somebody else's mercy. My story was almost, very similar. And, I was going through troubled times, almost like more than a couple of years back. And Piyush Prabhu and I, spent some time, Piyush Prabhu was running a Karun Alley where, he was basically trying to reform juvenile, criminals, so to say, kids, by way of spirituality. And, I spent some time with him, and that's where, I went to ISKCON for the first time. When I was not going through the right times, I really went to the temple and I cried a lot. I really cried a lot in front of Prabhupadji, and I was like that, what is happening to my life? I'm really confused. I need some direction. And it was in 2015, January 1st, 2016, like Raghunath Prabhu, I used to drink as well. So I think January 1st, 2016, I really decided to, take a very different life, like completely abstain from everything, leave completely change my life, realign, get into chanting. And, over the last 2 years, of course, I've spent a lot of time, looking at the Shastras, of course, I would put myself as I've just been admitted to a school where you've been studying for the last few years or you're very much there. And it's been very blissful. It's been you can feel Krishna's mercy on you. And last year I moved to Bombay, so that's when I kind of more regularly started going to ISKCON Chowpatti, like every Sunday going to Srimad Bhagavatam lectures, and had the opportunity to come here, spend time. And I really seek your blessings that I can move forward in my journey, and that's all I have to say.
How many rounds you are chanting now?
So, Prabhuji, I try to do at least, I'll be honest, 5 rounds for the weekdays, but at least go up to 16 rounds on the weekends.
But minimum is 5.
Yeah. So I really ensure that, because it has been up and down for a long time, but then I promised myself that I will, in the attempt to do 16 at times, what happened, I was not being able to. So at least I promised that I will do at least 5, and weekends I will aim for 16.
My suggestion would be that you increase that minimum step by step, not sudden. Now if I, maybe in a month you say that I should go up to 16. and slowly, slowly pulls. Suddenly you see your minimum is again 60. Okay. So thank you very much for this, for coming. And three times Hari Bol, Tripadi Prabhu.
Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol.
Let me assure you that this world is always full of reverses. Very few realize it. So it is nothing surprising that you have gone through certain reverses in your life. But the reverses are the nature of this world. And unless we have Bhagavad Gita with us, we will not be able to face such reverses. So you are very fortunate, in fact, to come in contact with the Prabhupada literature. And I can assure you that your life will be very sublime. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Please, please take this. This is the gift. Yes. Hare Krishna. Hare
Krishna. I am neither an academic student of Sir, neither a student of IIT Kanpur. I have completed my PhD from IIT Bombay. And in 2015, I joined as a scientist at IIT Kanpur in the Science Department. Like science student from first standard to 10th standards, I have a cultural background from my home and I believe in God and all those things. लेकिन जैसे जैसे हम साइंस पढ़ते जाते हैं वैसे वैसे हमारा भगवान से भरोसा उठता है एंड वी यूज टू आस्क सो मेनी क्वेश्चन एंड देर इज नो वन अराउंड अस टू गिव द आंसर ऑफ दैट क्वेश्चन सो दैट इज द मेन रीजन वी लूज बिलीव ऑन गॉड देन आई यूज टू वॉच वीडियो ऑफ जाकिर नाइक So indirectly, I should get some information. But in one video, he talk about Bhagavad Gita, and he informed the wrong information. Then I suddenly know, if I don't know this literature, then how can I know others? So first of all, it is very important to know our culture. And then Venkat Prabhu was the neighbor in Kotak. And then I asked him some questions.
Where is Venkat?
So I asked certain questions to him. So he told me that this Bhagavad Gita workshop is going on in IIT Kanpur. So just come there and you will get the answer of all your questions. So I joined that Bhagavad Gita workshop. And I was the only participant in that workshop. Who has a lot of list of questions written on the paper. So first day and second day sir asked any question or tisse din se sir direct bolte the ha atish and again the prasadam is the secret I start my bhakti and then 10th class tak I was very thin and short So family member and relative suggest me to eat egg. Then I started non-veg. फिर college में गया लड़कियों को impress करने के चक्कर में body building बन नहीं रही थी तो लोगों ने suggest किया कि beer पियो फिर वो भी चालू किया फिर बॉम्बे में गया फिर बॉम्बे में भी वही कल्चर पार्टी फ्राइडे नाइट सैटरडे संडे ऑफ तो उसी कल्चर में मैं चला गया बैठे गया लेकिन जब यहाँ पे आया भगवद गीता का थोड़ा सा नॉलेज मुझे मिला थोड़ी सी फिलोसॉफी मिली सर का गाइडेंस मिला और मेरी लाइफ ड्रास्टिक चेंज हुआ और अभी ऐसा लगता है कि अगर मैं यहाँ नहीं आता तो फिर मेरी लाइफ क्या होती थी एंड ऑफकोर्स आई कैन नॉट स्पीक अबाउट सर एंड माता जी क्योंकि आई एम वेरी इमोशनल तो लास्ट आपने एक्सपीरियंस किया होगा कि आई कैन नॉट कंट्रोल माई टीयर्स सो आई से कि Same feeling like Venkat Prabhu. So Hare Krishna.
Three times Hari Bol to Atish.
Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol.
Atish is actually now teaching in IIT Nagpur. He finished his PhD here in material science, and he is now in Nagpur. He is also in touch with the devotees there. He has a very nice son who was regular in Bhagavad Gita. You see that in Bhagavad Gita, everybody, all adults are sitting. His son will be sitting very peaceful, not moving at all. Right. I wish your son, your family members, well. Thank you for coming. Hare Krishna. And one more for your family. Now we have long list. I would say all of them to come here. Sudhir, Ajay, Sunil, together. तुम तीनों एक बैच ना एक जूनियर है एक सीनियर
है
सेम बैच सेम बैच
एंड
यू सी दिस आंध्रा ग्रुप यू आर हियरिंग फ्रॉम बैंकेट राइट So he was talking about Andhra group. You see, this is Andhra group.
Two more are there. Two more are there. Just one Krishna.
Kartik.
Immediately when I came here, first I saw that the Janmashtami call for participation, like this, for participation for services notice. And after that, at the time, Mahatu caught me. he engaged me in distributing flyers. So initially, I told that I'm interested in Janmashtami arts work. Like, then he engaged me in distributing flyers. And then once I conducted a lecture series, reincarnation, I attended that lecture immediately, next day there is a program, and immediately Mahaprabhu taught me and come for the program. In Lankeshwar there is a program for 2 days. I went there, not very serious, but every day Mahaprabhu used to call me. Every day I used to sleep in the room and Mahaprabhu would call me, where is it? Why are you not coming? And I used to say, on the way, on the way. daily trip to Mahaprabhu. And after many days, I understood whenever I used to skip him, my work doesn't usually happen. I used to think, if I go him, my work doesn't happen. Anyhow, something used to happen, my work doesn't happen. Whatever I plan, my plans would be failed. That better to go by whenever. Sir used to scold me, why are you, how many chants around you used to chant, I told later on, still later on, sir used to scold, and after 1.5 years you just push me, you chant 16 rounds, then I chanted 16 rounds. I was about to take sir as guide, but I did not take sir guide because I feared, if I take sir as guide, then I have to become Hare Krishna. And after I took him, my life is gone. My life is full of difficulties. And then I practice sincerely. And then I went after my MTech got extended. I went in Bangalore for 4.5 months like that. Like in Bangalore also, I did not like that city life. Like very hectic life. Like I used to like work like anything. Still like other is there not happy. Actually everyone is like work so hard. I did not understand why people are like low position, high position. Everyone is working so hard. Like from morning to evening, everyone used to stay like there only. Like only one boss is there. Like everyone is working for him. Like I. During MTech, like sir used to teach for three of us. Daily morning program, he used to teach like he used to instruct. You three people has to start a tribal school in Andhra Pradesh. Like he used to give many days he told like you three people has to start a tribal project, tribal school. Like this tribal people, when you give Krishna consciousness, they become very very interpreted and they become very strong. Like they used to tell like that, and then like he used to tell many plans about that, that your body has to have a big lake in between, and in the between there should be temples. Like he used to tell like then. And when I'm going for job, I told that I'll work. I told sir that I'll work for 2 years, then I'll come. I'll start. I'll do work on your project, like school. Then after like 4.5 months, like my job is gone. Then I told sir like I told that I'll find a good job. After 2 years I'll come. Then sir told no one will you come. At that time you are here in Vrindavan, there is a job for you. You work under Vinodji. He called. Then I came to Vrindavan. Like then actually I was very fed up with city life in Bangalore. I came to like Vrindavan. I used to live in a bigger city, and all like agriculture I used to do, I worked on low cost farming, low cost housing, everything like I learned so many all these things. And again in New Land also it became little hectic, and somehow I had to run back here. Then again, sir motivated, and again I went to Vrindavan. Then Vrindavan under Radhakant Prabhu, I was sir. work in Dehradun, not Dehradun, he told for Bhagavad Gita, with Sunil. Then again, Matsun Prabhu came and father leadership. We are doing very well.
Thank you. Thank you.
Actually, Sudeep Prabhu is my senior from my BTEC days. I know him from Andhra Pradesh only. So he only encouraged me to come here to IIT Kanpur. Then after coming, he did not stress much about the group, but it is I met devotees before only. Like once they came to my room asking for the Bhagavad Gita lecture series. Then I told I am not interested. And then I think Sudeep Prabhu I know, Mahabhu I know, because they are all Telugu background. That also I did not attend actually. I am not that much interested. Like I am like little fruitive. If something advantage is there for me, then only I will go in general. So actually Sudhir Prabhu is my senior, so obviously we need senior's help in our projects. So once he gave me a little service in Janmashtami, so I did that. Some posters I pasted in Hale. So for that they told, after that I Janmashtami I did not attend, but I posters I pasted. Then later they told whoever did little service also will give some gift. So they arranged a program, so for that gift I went. So then in that gift, in that sir gave lecture actually. That is little scientific. I did not really understand much, but lot of inquisitiveness is there to understand what sir is telling. Like some bottle is there on the table, so you are all seeing this bottle, but this bottle is not here. That's yes, something is there. Really, he is talking seriously. I need to understand this thing. So, next day onwards, I was became little. I was going to Mangalarti and I was trying to attend the program. So it is very nice experience, and mainly the entire room, almost everybody is Telugu people only. Like in sometimes when we were in kitchen services, like Mata is alone. Odia, and we are all Telugu, and we will talk something. Talk something, something is like, Mata will ask, what you learn? You are talking about me, right? So, those are wonderful days, like, and mainly, the relations are very nice, and service is also not that much hectic, because all our leaders are there. Like Venkat Prabhu, Vedansut Prabhu, Mehar Prabhu and Tarun Prabhu. These four are mainly taking care of all the areas. They are just engaging us whenever needed. So it is not overloaded also. Like my life in IIT Kanpur, it is very nice days. Like service is also not too much actually. And then my interest is also building up. Like initially I was preparing for engineering services. Then after some time I thought, okay, the time is not, I'm not getting time, I want to spend some time more in consciousness. Then I went to sir and I told, sir, I don't want to do that, I want to do some PhD program and I want to learn more, something like that. Then sir told, okay, fine, first you complete M.Tech. Then after that, in ISKCON Kanpur, one inauguration ceremony was there. Then I have seen so many brahmacharis are there, the culture is very nice. Then I thought, sir, I cannot do PhD also, I want to become a joining table, something like that. And then sir promised, okay, we'll do something like that, we'll arrange for you. A little seriously he told. Then after that, at the completion of my course, suddenly when he was in Vrindavan, some requirement is there, teacher requirement in Vrindavan, chemistry teacher. So sir called me and then I agreed, then I was in Vrindavan. And after going to Vrindavan, it is like little alone only, because my age group, all my friends are here and I am there little alone, and connection with sir also not that much there. But still, it is every day, it is like a new realization, revelations, and morning chanting hours are very nice in Vrindavan. Whatever experience I have in Kanpur, same was there also in Vrindavan, even if we are alone. Somehow Radharani, Krishna helps us. And mainly I took the association of books, Prabhupada books, as well as like Sachinanda Maharaj, Gaur Govind Maharaj, Bhaktivedanta Maharaj, these are the main Maharajas. Like they helped me a lot through their books, and now also I am continuing with that. So like that every day, those days, first year, second year, 1-2 years are very nice, because I am getting some time for sadhana also morning, and it is really nice. Like every day morning chanting time, some realization will come. Entire day will go on with that, and next day morning chanting, it is like it's flowing. Vrindavan days are very nice. I remembered more my Vrindavan days only than Kanpur days actually. Then after that, interaction with students became increased. Even though students create sometimes problems, but if we move closely, like sometimes we'll be see their innocence, we can sense that. Like even though they will do lot of nonsense, nuisance, but if we look something deep inside them, everybody has some nice qualities. They also want to share something actually. It is not that they want to create disturbance to disturb us. They are disturbed themselves, so they are disturbing us also. So I'm trying to understand slowly the dynamics of the students, and I'm coming to lower grades also like that. So mainly my interaction will be with students only entire day, because even I will stay in Brahmachari Ashram. It is just beside the students' room. So whenever they want, sometimes they will call me also, like if some emergencies are there. So it is like my 18 hours or 17 hours almost with the students only. So it was nice. Mainly, spiritually I am little happy there, here and as well as there also. So still I am sustaining. Materially I have some difficulties, because not that intelligent. I'm trying to cope up with my all my services. My management skills are little poor, and always like I'm in tension. So whenever sir, Radhakant Prabhu, Hargesh Prabhu, their only question is, are you happy or not? First, they are not worried much about my academics or what. They will ask this only, are you happy or not? So I'm very thankful to all of them for caring me till now, and I need their guidance. And thank you very much for IIT people for giving me this opportunity here. Thanks to everyone.
Hari Bol!
Hari Bol! Hari Bol! Sir, he's a good dedicated teacher. Correct? Okay. Sunil, tell you.
Sorry.
I came to IIT Kanpur with many hopes, many hopes in all fields. I took studies and I did that also in Sharjah. I did my bachelor's in Raipur. So, like at the end of during my final year, I was in a lot of trouble in the sense that, as you all know, like, we listen to, like in bachelor's or master's, we listen to our seniors. We don't even listen to professors, but we listen to, we give more preference to what seniors say. So like, they used to say, you don't have to worry, don't worry, just go into this placement cell. You just have to go inside and you will get placed. I was in electrical, so I was just following them, and I didn't study much. I just barely maintained my pointer. And at the final stage, what happened was few companies were there, like Coal India, the PSUs were there. They used to come and they just used to take people. But from that year, they decided not to just go to these NITs and IITs. Instead, we'll take them through GATE. So like I was in trouble. I was surprised. I was I don't know. I was completely baffled. Like, what is happening? Then I started reading, and I don't like. It is a surprise to all my classmates also. Like I got a good rank. Like nobody expected. Like I got 265. Like everybody surprised. Even the first person also not. And even myself, I am surprised how I got such a good rank. Because I didn't study much, but examination paper was like it consisted only those questions which I know. Apart from that, I don't know anything. Somehow I got here. And during those interviews, I met Ajay Prabhu. Like I was with him for all interviews, Kharagpur, Kanpur, Chennai, and Delhi. Then after I come, like during my holidays, I used to think I should not repeat the same thing. Somehow by Krishna's grace, I used to do business with Balaji, Lord Balaji, because I am I stay at a place near to Tirupati. Like, it's very near, so I used to go to Lord and I used to deal business dealings with there. So I used to pay a lot. Please give me, if you give this, they'll give me like that. And like we here also, like if we sincerely pray, I don't know what sincerity Lord has
said.
Yes,
Andraja, Vinayak.
He has given me this opportunity to come to IIT Kanpur. As somebody mentioned earlier also, I also think that the only reason why I came to IIT Kanpur is to meet sir and to meet devotees, except that I don't find any reason. And after coming here also, I tried the same old things which I resolved not to do. But I just after coming here, I started playing, I started meeting friends. I wanted to be like a kind of boss, and like, I was serving all my classmates, including Ajay Prabhu. And like, when the first time I met him during interviews, I was like, do you want any films? Please take. I have so many films. As I was in electrical, I had to take such course. So in that class, that was the first moment. What struck me was, as Ajay Prabhu told, sir was teaching like in a very different way. Like I remember sir showed a chalk piece, and sir was asking what are you seeing here? So everybody, like mostly four or five Bengalis were there, and other 4 or 5 hundreds were there, and 2 or 3 others were there. So everybody started speaking, these are molecules, atoms, light is reflecting, that this. Then sir gave interesting answer that which I don't remember. Then I was continuing with my like regular routine. Then I was playing one day with with my other classmates. So that time somebody told that there is a Bhagavad Gita lecture series going on. So and they were a little intelligent, and I thought, okay, anyway, I have tried so much, why don't I go? Then that's how I started with them. But all those, that day like 7 or 8 people we went together. Ajay Prabhu was not there, and like except me, everybody is nobody is here. I'm the only person. Anyway, they left on that day itself. So for the first time when I was in that lecture, I saw our Vedant Sudhu. Then slowly I met our Manohar Chaitanya Prabhu, Sudhir Prabhu, Karun Prabhu, and Ajay Prabhu was also there. And Ajay Prabhu has helped me a lot in my journey because he was intelligent fellow, he was a 10 pointer. I was motivated by him as well. And after that, like once I came in contact with devotees, after coming to chanting, after coming here and I started practicing, I was very much impressed by such lectures, as everybody is impressed by. But I could not understand much, and even now I don't understand much. But I just try to like follow whatever I could understand. And during my initial days, one time after chanting few rounds, I was able to see like there are so many faults with myself. I could see like I am very envious of others, especially Ajay Prabhu. I was envious of many people. I was seeing all my bad things. So I wrote everything on a list, and I went to sir. I showed to sir. Sir just saw like a few things. Then immediately sir called Re Vipul Prabhu. Then Vipul Prabhu came and sir scolded Vipul Prabhu like anything. Hey, what are you doing? This fellow is suffering like anything. What are you doing? I was surprised. What is happening? But sir told, from that day I got association of Vedant Sudhu Prabhu. Like he was with me personally. Like we used to stay together in college. Then came a very interesting part, which where our Sarvagikaran Prabhu's his role comes. After first semester we were supposed to choose a guide. Then I was not very good in control systems. I was a little bit better in power electronics. So I was like thinking whom to approach. By that time I know Mahaprabhu and Sarvagikaran Prabhu. And anyway, he was working with Sen Sharma, with whom I wanted to work with. So I met Prabhuji. Prabhuji, like what should I do? I am confused. Please let me know. Whom should I select? Then Prabhuji confused me even more. Then I thought better contact somebody else. Then anyway, I got a search shelter. Then from the very first day, sir nurtured me very carefully. He was giving a lot of association to me. I don't know how sir got to know, but sir gave chance. Sir engaged me in playing with him. Like, there's also a seva. In that way, I was engaged. I was playing with sir all the time. But I don't know how sir got to know that I can play. Then
that is very Venkat. Venkat recommended that Sunil is a good badminton player.
Then sir is known for his curiosity in the lab, because sir scolds like anything, because that is necessary also. But during my 2 years here, sir never scolded me. Like it was already 2015 and I was supposed to complete my master's, but I barely did anything. But sir never asked me, or never even pushed me, or told anything. Hey, what are you doing? What are your plans? Sir never asked me. Like sir was very cool with me. Sir never asked anything, or scolded me about my research. And like sir was always planning for us ahead in future. Like Sarvagikaran Prabhu told, sir always used to tell like this is the project you are going to do that. And it really helped.
Actually, I don't like my life is gone and now you take only like I did not take sir as guide. I lost a chance. You take sir as guide.
So in that way, like sir nurtured me all the way. Then as Venkat Prabhu also mentioned, sir was very conscious of whatever he speaks, whatever he does, and like as we used to come every day. Like Ajay Prabhu used to there so much motivation. We used to come every Mangalarti. Then sir gave us opportunity to go to a retreat from where we started chanting like 16 rounds. Then slowly we got in touch with Mataji, children. Then it became a family because not much of what is given here I got from home. Though everything was there, it's not that my parents were bad, but I could not get what I'm getting here over there. So everything was motivating, and then comes like devotees, all the devotees, especially Venkat Prabhu and Meher Prabhu. Meher Prabhu had a course with me, and he used to come to my room all the time in the disguise of studying. He used to get prasadam for me, and I was thinking, oh, this is nice. But I was at the same time I was thinking, why this fellow comes always? I was like that, but Meher Prabhu, he is known for his tolerance, patience. He never stopped. He always used to come. And he also, Rashad, he used to bring. And Tarun Prabhu also, he calls me. Oh, you are coming? He used to motivate. And there was a Telugu batch, so that also helped a lot. Then, after that, after my result was not that much, then sir sent me to do something. Go get lost from here, sir sent me to Abu Dhabi. Then somehow I could not stay there also. Like what I would like to say is, as our Balaji Prabhu told, like whatever situation we may be in, like it was like I was thinking if I would have been there, it would have been better. And when I go there, I'll think, why I came here? That would have been better. So difficulties are there always, but better take the spirituality. So that's how I was feeling. Then I came here, sir, gave this service of Learn Gita, and I could not do much. But anyway, sir was so much tolerant. Sir was tolerant with me all the way. Like be it my thesis, be it spirituality, be it my service, and even now service so much tolerant, and is giving chances again and again. And now we are with Madhusudan Prabhu and Sarvagauram Prabhu is there. We are in Dehradun trying to do something. And please give your blessings. Please forgive me if I have done something wrong, and I am short-tempered also. I scolded devotees many times. Please forgive me for that, and I am very grateful to sir, and I'll try to do whatever I can.
When we were having retreat in Rishikesh, his mother came and he stayed there. She was the lone woman in that retreat. And then I learned from Sunil that his mother, after coming in contact with Krishna consciousness, she has forgotten her family name. She goes wherever Sudhar Maharaj or anybody giving class, she learns. Right? So, I thought, why you have to now waste your time? He said that I'll do again PhD. I said, get lost. See, if you can make now struggle a little bit, your future will be brighter. But now you enter into again complexity, you know, life will be very complex. Now one has to be really very bright. You know, I had maximum hope from people. You know, he has not delivered. I'm here, I don't do PhD research. Students come and they do. I have no interest in this so-called research. Here they have zero value as far as I see about Krishna is concerned. Only bright people you can think they can bring something. Otherwise, you know, it's a big headache being a PhD. What do you get from there? He went wasted his life. In malaria research. What is this? We are not able to establish that life forms are there in every planetary system. That's so important for us. We don't understand what is space. Okay? So, thank you, three of you. Give Hari Bol three times.
Hari Bol! Hari Bol! Hari Bol!
And bless them, they're very young. Bless them that they should completely dedicate their life to Krishna. Yes, now Golu and Dilip. Golu, Dilip, tired. Dilip, Adam. It is shocking for me to hear Dilip is doing PhD. Come. Golu, Adam, tell me.
Just like one of our family says, in school life, our teacher says that God doesn't exist. So this happens to me. One of my English teacher always says that God is nowhere. God is like your imagination. But one day, with my mother and my family, I went to Vrindavan when I was in school only. And then, when we go to Dwarkadesh, I have a different feeling that I can't explain. Like, I was feeling very happy in Dwarkadesh. So then I think, no, there is something which affects us. Then, this is the first moment when I realized that there is God, kind of energy which makes us happy also. And take our distress and other things from us. But then I come home and do nothing. And then one more trip, I feel good. So I'm getting a taste of Krishna after going to Vrindavan. Then one of my friend told me that there is ISKCON temple in Delhi. Just go to me. Please go to me. Go to me. We will have some prasadam and meet some devotees. Then I went to there and take the lecture. I have so many questions and I asked them. I don't get satisfactory answers. And then after that I got admission in IIT. Then I came here. When I was residing in Hall 11 and I see a template that there is a lecture on Bhagavad Gita. So, bye sir. So I think ki in IIT someone is teaching Bhagavad Gita, so I have to go and listen what he is saying. Then I come and attend that lecture. And in that lecture, I have so many questions like, In the lecture, sir was talking about paap. So I asked him, "What sir, why we do paap?" So he gave me a very answer, which I don't able to understand. Like, we forgot Krishna, then we do paap. So I'm not able to digest how ये क्या हो रहा है। We forgot Krishna, then we do paap. मैं तो Krishna को भी याद कर रहा हूँ, तब भी paap हो जाता है। Then I ask some more question. Then I come back to sir. Then I ask the same question, and he told me that you have to be with devotees, then you will be able to totally connect with Krishna. Or else, alone you can't get connection with Krishna. So I tried to be with devotees, but due to some circumstances, and some depression and very much pressure in the environment, I also got separated and do so many nonsense here. But in that lecture, Tarun Prabhu has, I got contact with Tarun Prabhu. And he always contact me and ask me what are you doing, and always try to contact me and say ki aao ji, aao yahan pe, attend karo lecture, you will feel good. And then I not very much, but I come.
gradually come. And after coming here, I came in summer camp. I was in summer when I second year started. So I come here regularly. I was feeling very good. I was like, yeah, this is totally good thing. This is now my life will feel easy to me. Before that it was very difficult. And then it become easy, but now then again. I become again trapped with this Maya again. So go again to that Maya. And then this seesaw is still not stopped. I also I started to do Krishna conscious. I started doing chanting in Kanpur. I do chant around 4 to 8. Around 2-4-8 I'm doing malas. Yeah, sometimes I sleep also. So I was feeling good. But then I got degree from IIT Kanpur, go to home and do some practice. Tarun Prabhu came to Delhi, he introduced me with some bhaktas there also. I got contact with them for 4-5 months, and then due to some irregularities, I also started skipping those lectures. Like the first 2 times they don't have on Friday, and then I thought ki now they are not taking the lectures. So then that irregularity start coming, and then their Prabhuji's are also helping me, and yes. So I'm also in seesaw with Maya and Krishna. So maybe I will balance in this world with this Maya and Krishna, I think. So yes, I want to add one thing, that I had a very nice escape from this Maya. Very, very shortcut to get escape from this Maya. Then when you are tapping in this Maya, just call to Prabhuji. He will give you a very nice advice, but for fulfilling that advice, you have to follow one instruction, that chant. Without chanting, you can't follow his instruction. So then you have to chant, and then you will be easily escaped from that time, from the Maya. So I'm trying to do chanting as much as possible, and I think I will be saved from this Maya.
So I came here in 2010 and passed out in 2014. So I always had mercy of sir, that he always remembered me, although I was not a good student and I was not a sincere practitioner. But my only qualification was that he always remembered me, and few devotees also told me that although sir is not attached to anyone, but for some reason he keeps asking about you. So I think that helped me maintain till date. So once even sir visited my room along with Vedant Sutra Guru. So there was a slight knock on the door, and then I opened and behind Vedant Sutra Guru sir was standing. So Vedant Sutra Guru was very sorry for this, that he didn't inform me that sir at my house. So he kept apologizing for a week or so. Next time again, sometime there was a slow knock on the door at same time. So I was so terrified that I wish that there should have been a tap in the room and I should have taken bath before opening the door, but that was not the case. So after going also from here, I remember that once everything in my life was disturbed and I was not in a good condition, I came to sir, and sir and Mataji fed me dinner with them, and that was very touching, and from that point everything turned around and everything came on track. So like I heard from a devotee that when you read Bhagavatam, so there was a question that when you read Bhagavatam, I don't remember as I continue reading, so what about that?
So he said that it is not important to remember everything, but when the time comes, you will remember the things. So whenever I am in a big trouble, so although I have heard so many things, I have listened, I have seen so many things, but when there is a deep trouble, coming down to basics, I just remember that what sir has taught me. And last year was not a very good for me. I had fracture in my leg. I had to leave my job. I had to do bed rest for 3 months. Then I joined a job in August or September, but then...
What was that?
Hello.
So although I got a job, but then there were a few health issues because I gained a lot of weight, and then I was not able to work. I had to leave my job, and I was in a big trouble. So I wanted to meet sir, although Mahaprabhu I see here is so busy, but still he would attend my call, listen to me patiently. And then I told him that I want to meet sir. So he kept calling me, but I couldn't find time because I couldn't travel alone, and then to bring somebody with me was a problem. So therefore I couldn't come, but I just told Mahaprabhu that just go and tell sir that I am in some problem. So I don't know whether he told or not, but from that day everything turned around, and again within a week I was fine with the problem, which was continuing from 4-5 months. And then again I am trying to do something professionally also, and I am grateful for sir's mercy, and I just cannot describe. Venkat Prabhu has already told a lot about his lectures and all. And his lectures are very popular also in different places. So once I met a devotee and he told that he was connected to IIT Jodhpur. So he said that Hila Purushottam Tuya, he gives lecture about space. So once I visited Noida Temple, and I invited him, so he came. He's a very senior and very nice devotee, but he said that I'm fearful that what if he gives a lecture on space. And sir actually started a lecture on space. So he immediately fled away. He said that in 60 minutes I develop 100 doubts. But then he came after some time, and then he listened to everything and said that yes, sir has a different taste and a different mood of delivering lectures, and the point of view from where he is telling is unheard from anywhere. So there is nothing, not much to tell about me, but I came here just to be thankful and express my gratitude to sir and Mataji, and pray for his mercy always, because that is what something tangible I hold in my life. Thank you, sir.
Please give this to nice devotees. Three times
Hari Bol.
So Vinita is now doing creating a course material for school education. Harikas, please be in touch with him, and somehow engage him in some service to the group. Okay? And Venkat and Vinayak and Saurabh. Tum aise kaise ja rahe ho? Main to kal jana chahiye tha. Okay, 200 people to jaate. Everybody wants to get. Venkat, you take your gift. Bolo, jaldi bolo. He came, but he was only serving. He was bolo.
I came in 2009. So when I joined, I was so much frustrated because I was not happy at all, feeling like where am I. Somehow from my childhood identity affected towards Krishna. So then after 15 days, I think probably without informing everyone, I took a general ticket and left for Vrindavan. For 2 days, some weekend was there longing. And then I, when I Janmashtami, the first Janmashtami in India, I went to Skon Kanpur because I was not aware of this. And because Shrikant was there, so I met him in the temple. Actually, he was my BA or BSc, whatever. So then in the lab after Janmashtami, he told me that why you have to go to that path, you can come here only, we have programs. So I remember first time I came with one of my friends. Actually, first year boys, some program was organized, some cricket match was there on that day. So nobody came in, and I think two more guys were there. And I remember that sir asked the first question, what is the most dangerous situation you have ever faced in your life? So I thought, I suffered actually from jaundice, very severe. So I told that. And some others also told some example. So, and he also told like, what is the most dangerous situation you can think of? And so again, something like that. And then he said, don't think of all these things, think about death. What will happen when you die? So, I haven't thought about it in that manner any time before. So, yeah, like that, and then I started coming back to the
then we could go to Venkatapuru.
I learned a lot from Venkatapuru, especially the service attitude and all that. I'm very much inspired. And then, yeah, I never missed after that, like, that home sickness or whatever you can say, which I was suffering from in the beginning. After I started coming, like, once Mataji told, I don't remember the context exactly, but ye to mera beta hai, aise karke bolte the, to that parental affection and that love which we got from Sahaj Mataji, that is indescribable. I'm not doing anything, but thankful to say that we're still concerned about my spiritual value so much that it's continuously trying to do my faithful prayers and that there's something I'm able to do for the service.
Kirtan kyun nahi kiya re is tarah? Three times Hari Bol.
Hari Bol. Hari Bol. Hari Bol.
A person who has done experiment with death. Please.
So,
nine o'clock. Ah, this is going. 9 o'clock, na? Wake.
So I came.
I think we have to stop quickly.
So I came to IIT in 2012, and. So my first interaction was, I saw a poster sir had a lecture on reincarnation, and there was the picture of like the transmigration of the soul, but I thought of some kind of fantastical thing that you know, some kind of consciously being able to change bodies or something. I thought okay, some scientific research is probably being done about how you can inhabit other bodies or something like that. So I had seen posters and flyers for Janmashtami, but I never thought twice about even attending that. But when I saw this poster, I thought, okay, maybe something interesting, and I attended that. So in that, first I was shocked by sir, like there is this question, like somebody asked, sir asked, how do you know who is your father? Then someone in the audience said by DNA test, and started arguing and was kicked out of that lecture. So that whole thing was a little bit shocking. And means, yeah, he was politely told to leave. Like, yeah, means he left. But we know that immediately the next day there was one retreat, 2 days retreat in Lavkushvatika, and. I don't know why, but I registered for that, and so there I went, and so like while we were going in the auto, all the devotees were chanting, and like I was feeling a bit uncomfortable. I thought, oh my god, if I associate with them, is this what will happen to me? So then we went there, and like Mayank Prabhu was the first one who started preaching to me. Like he said, he started talking to me. He showed me the laws of book, laws of nature. And he told me about consequences of drinking and smoking. I thought, why are you telling me this thing? Like, I didn't know anything, like, okay, they're trying to teach me something or preach or anything. I just found everything to be very strange. And so the 2 days there were very good. And after that, Venkat Prabhu like took great interest in me. He used to invite me for Saturday programs. And in first year, so I started attending the Saturday programs. Like everyone, I was also enamored by Sir's lectures. And like once I think they went for our Pavan Prabhu's marriage, and I came on that Saturday and I saw that the house was locked completely. So, I don't know exactly if it was that incident or something else, but the whole house was completely locked and I thought maybe I'm at the wrong house or something. So I was interested basically in the beginning. So first year went like that, and in second year, like I had many problems, like some kind, I still don't. Like, I have a really bad memory. I can't recall exactly all the events which transpired during that time, but I slowly, my psychological state was not very healthy. Like at one point, like I was living my usual life, but once sir looked at me and he said, why do you appear to be in a pool of tears? So that was what he asked. I thought, like, this is how I normally am, but he could see that I was in some kind of stress. So he, like Vinit Prabhu said, like in Krishna consciousness, I've always been thinking, okay, someday I'll have some kind of mystical experience or something, and so that like I'll know some kind of self-evident experience where all the doubts will disappear, so that I need, like, I've been obsessed with this kind of compulsive thinking that, I have to find some kind of rational foundation. So what is behind this? And so I used to be tormented by that, and I would think that unless some kind of self-evident thing happens, how is it going to be resolved? But like one of the really great mystical things in my life, I would say, is the presence of Sir and Mataji. Because like today Sir was discussing about Mrigari and others. So like if I really tell you sincerely, I have not done any service. I was not regular in chanting during the 4 years. And like, and I've always been like, in during my third, fourth year, the situation was such that devotees would come to my room and I would go somewhere else and hide because it was really horrible. But still, somehow, sir was always merciful, and like sir used to chastise me a lot. I used to have dreams at night that sir was chasing. Always, sir used to call, like devotees used to bring me after the class that sir is calling me. Somehow they used to drag me. So always sir used to chastise me and then feed me prasadam. So I think the only thing, only devotion sir used to say, it was taking the prasadam of course. Like my situation was so bad, I used to be sleeping whole day, and when I would be awake, I would think, okay, today I have to fix that. This is the, like, this is the rational basis, I'll settle on this, and from tomorrow I'll start following this. And I would start along the train of thought, I would be tired and go back to sleep. So this was the cycle. So I would not eat for 2-3 days in a row, or just I would take some food or something.
Like I would buy some huge stack of fruits and keep it, and when I was hungry I would eat and go back to sleep. So really just nonsense. So I used to be hungry at the end of the week. So when I used to come for prasadam, I used to take like really a lot of prasadam. So devotees would be surprised, how is he taking so much prasadam? But that was because I would be fasting for long periods of time. So that was how my time at IIT passed. So after leaving IIT, so then I have recently joined a job because of some family pressure, but I really prayed to the Lord that I can come back and serve under the guidance of Sir. Like one confidence that I got, like they say that this is like some kind of a fountain which keeps on giving water. Like I always used, like sometimes I used to wish that, okay, like I used to also feel tormented that I am unable to, like some kind of guilt that Sir, I am unable to reciprocate. Like maybe a stone will probably reciprocate better than my kind of negative reciprocation. So, I don't know, but still, so finally, I don't know, some kind of faith that, like even if that Sir will probably, even if it comes to that stage, maybe Sir will drag by me by my hair to Goloka. This I never lose this relationship with Sir, and that I can continue to serve.
Okay, three times Hari Bol. I think we finished. It was nice that they all still there.
Manish.
How? Okay, go. You miss your. Will you leave now? Right, 9 o'clock, na? What time it is now?
7. Quarter to 8.
7:45.
Please.
Just
tell them
what you want
to take question.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Please give 3 times
Hari Bol
to Manish Prabhu. Hari Bol. Sir, you see that he's a young boy, right? Anybody who wants to be united with Krishna, he has to be ever young, right? Thank you. Right. Okay, Adore! Manish Abhi, head of the department, hai? In math?
Physics
head of the department in coaching institute in Pune, Ahmednagar. Bolo.
I would like to thank every one of you for giving me this opportunity to ask something, so to tell something. Actually, I am not that much qualified, but still, you all are so merciful, so that you gave me a chance to speak. I will say sorry first all of you, that if I made some comments, offenses against you, so I will maaf karna. So, mera 2013 तो वो 6 स्टूडेंट को साथ-साथ में कमरा दिया जाता है एक कमरे में दो जन रहते हैं 2 स्टूडेंट तो हम 6 लोगों को साथ में बिठा करके उन लोगों ने बताया, तो मुझे सब फील होगा कि उस टाइम पर तो मुझे ऐसा लगा कि सब वही है, मतलब गीता देंगे पैसा ले लेंगे हमसे, तो बस गीता तो आता है हमको क्या बोल रहा है सब पता है सबकी जरूरत क्या है, तो उस टाइम पे इतना कन्विक्शन नहीं आया, बट मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि अगर उस टाइम पे ही अगर कन्विक्शन आ गया होता तो ज़्यादा बेटर था, बहुत प्रगति कर ली होती उन टाइम, तो वो रिग्रेट करता हूँ मैं उस टाइम को कि मैं कितना मूर्ख आदमी था उस समय, मुझे ज्वाइन कर लेना चाहिए था उस तो उसके बाद जब 2 साल और गुजर गए, 2 साल मैंने बहुत गंदी हरकतें की, सब टाइप की हरकतें कर डाली थी मैंने, और हर गालियाँ ए टू जेड मुझे याद थी सर और विदाउट पे गाली मेरा कोई लाइन नहीं होता था
सर ये जब जाता था तो हरिओम पंडित गुरु साथ हरिओम हर चल गुरु कोई देख ले रहा हूँ जिसके साथ
हूँ
कहाँ है हरिओम कहाँ है अच्छा क्या सचमुच है क्या ये करे हैं इतना डरता था हैं
पर इतना फेमस था मनीष
फेमस था गलत चीज तो फिर थर्ड ईयर में एक बार मैं मतलब मैं ऐसा बिल्कुल ऐसा नहीं बोल सकते कि पूरा ही नास्तिक था मैं विश्वास रखता था उस टाइम पे और मैं फास्टिंग करता था ट्यूसडे की बट वो फास्टिंग का मुझे मीनिंग नहीं पता था एक्चुअली फास्टिंग करना सिर्फ ये नहीं है कि आप एक दिन छोड़ दे बस ये सब कुछ दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल फास्टिंग मीन्स यू शुड फॉलो व्हाट एवर लॉर्ड वांट्स फ्रॉम यू हाउ यू प्लीज लॉर्ड बट ऐसा कुछ मेरा नहीं था मेरा था हनुमान जी है हनुमान जी का टेम्पल में जाना है और हनुमान चालीसा पढ़ना है और अगरबत्ती लगाना है पूजा पाठ करना है और बाकी सब कंटिन्यू यू कैन कंटिन्यू आप गाली दे सकते हैं आप किसी का मजाक बना सकते हैं कुछ भी कर सकते हैं हर्ट कर सकते हैं दैट इज ओके ऐसा ही है मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल अभी भी जो मेरे गांव में है सब चलता है ऐसे यही सब चलता है सब जगह मोस्ट ऑफ जगह पर लेकिन फिर एक दिन मैं डिबेट कर रहा था क्योंकि मैं मीट ईटिंग नहीं करता था स्टार्टिंग से ही तो एक दिन मैं डिबेट कर रहा था अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ तो शशि प्रभु ने मुझे देखा कि यार he is a qualified person I should preach so that is the sir aadha ek ghanta discussion hone ke baad mein wo mere room pe aate hain aur meethi meethi baatein start karte hain wo bolte hain ki aap kab se hanuman ji follow kar rahe hain kab se aap ye fasting karte hain kab se aap meeting nahi kiye hain batata hu तो मेरे को ऐसा लगता है ये क्यों पूछ रहा है सब तो फाइनली वो बोलते हैं कि एक यहाँ पर एक प्रोफेसर है और वो बहुत बड़े साइंटिस्ट हैं मैंने कहा होंगे फिर उन्होंने कहा कि वही नहीं वो जो है स्पिरिचुअल लेक्चर्स भी देते हैं मैंने कहा स्पिरिचुअल लेक्चर फिर उन्होंने कहा कि गीता पे जैसे होता है भगवद गीता पर तो मैंने फिर से वही बात बोली उनको कि गीता मुझे आती है लेकिन ये जानना चाहता था कि मतलब इतने हायर पोजीशन पे होकर के आप कैसे मतलब फॉलो कर सकते हैं कैसे आप क्योंकि जितने भी मैंने देखा है जैसे ज्यादातर लोग जो बहुत अमीर होते हैं जिनके पास सब कुछ होता है उनको भगवान की जरूरत नहीं है ऐसा लगता है लोगों को लेकिन स्टिल ही इज डूइंग इट मींस समथिंग इज देयर आई शुड गो एंड अटेंड द लेक्चर तो फिर वो मुझे लेक्चर में लेके आए भगवदगीता वाला क्लास जो सर ऑर्गेनाइज करवाया था उस पर लेके गए तो वहाँ पे सर से मैंने सुना मुझे सब कुछ एक्चुअली समझ में तो वही वाली बात है कि समझ में कुछ आ नहीं रहा था लेकिन अच्छा लग रहा था सुन करके कुछ ऐसा लग रहा था कि हाँ बिल्कुल डिफरेंट है और एकदम प्योरिटी आप फील कर सकते हैं प्योरिटी मतलब कि जैसे कोई बोलता है ना तो उसके शब्द और उसका रहन सहन और उसका बात करने का तरीका वो मिसमैच होने लगता है कभी कभी बट सर से मैंने सुना तो ऐसा लगा कि जो बोल रहे हैं वही है जो एकदम बोला है ना उन्होंने वो बिल्कुल फॉलो करते हैं और मैंने सुना भी है कि इस्कॉन में ये खास बात है कि लोग जो बोलते हैं ना वो फॉलो भी करते हैं दैट्स व्हाई देयर आर सो मेनी फॉलोअर्स ऑफ इस्कॉन बट बाकी का देखेंगे अगर आप सिर्फ बोलते हैं फॉलो नहीं कर पाते तो मैं धीरे धीरे फिर लेक्चर सुनने लगा मेरा और इंटरेस्ट बढ़ा प्रभु जी के साथ में आने लगा फिर बोला प्रसादम भी बहुत अच्छा अच्छा मिलता है तो प्रसादम से भी और अट्रैक्शन बढ़ा तो फिर धीरे धीरे मैं आने लगा सुनने लगा बुक रीडिंग करने लगा प्रभुपाद जी की तो
तो और इंटरेस्ट बढ़ता गया. फिर हम ट्रिप वगैरह पर जाते थे, ऋषिकेश ट्रिप वगैरह, जगन्नाथपुरी ट्रिप, बनारस ट्रिप, अलाहाबाद ट्रिप. तो इससे मेरे को मतलब काफ़ी रियलाइजेशन आने लगा. तो पहले मैं जहाँ मैं एक दो माला, तीन माला, चार माला करता था, फिर जगन्नाथपुरी में गया. तो जगन्नाथपुरी में जब जगन्नाथपुरी में मैं जैसे ही गया तो स्टार्टिंग से सर ने बोला कि आप जगन्नाथपुरी में आ चुके हैं, आपको बहुत ज़्यादा जप करना चाहिए. पहले मैं चार माला करता था, पांच माला, तो फिर मैं 16 करने लगा. एक दिन मैंने बोला मैंने 48 माला किए वहाँ पर. 48 माला क्यों किए, वो भी मैंने किसी से शर्त लगाई थी कि मैं आज 48 माला करूँगा. और कुछ था मतलब ऐसा कुछ था, 48 माला में करके दिखाऊंगा और तुमको ये करना. तो उस डेवोटी मतलब हाँ दूसरे डेवोटी को मैंने बोला कि आप 16 करेंगे आज और मैं 48 करूँगा. तो मैंने 48 किया और उन्होंने 16 किए. हाँ जितेंद्र रहा हो
हिमांशु था मैं
हिमांशु था क्या नहीं जितेंद्र
हिमांशु था
मैं. तो उन्होंने 16 राउंड्स किए और मैंने 48 राउंड्स किए.
हिमांशु एक से 16
नहीं करता था, चार पांच माला ही करता था. फिर उसके बाद जब हम टोटा गोपीनाथ टेम्पल में गए तो वहाँ जैसे बताते हैं कि चैतन्य महाप्रभु के डीटीज है जो गदाधर पंडित जब सेवा करते थे तो वो वृद्ध हो गए थे. तो उनसे ऊपर तक उनका सेवा नहीं हो पा रहा था. तो महाप्रभु झुक गए थे वहाँ पर. तो महाप्रभु के वैसे डिटीज है वहाँ पर बैठे हुए. तो वहाँ पर जो हिस्ट्री है जहाँ पर वो सभी लोग मिल करके भागवतम ध्रुव महाराज प्रहलाद महाराज के बारे में सुनते रहते थे. तो वहाँ पर जब आप रहेंगे, जब कीर्तन करेंगे तो आप उस चीज़ को फील कर सकते हैं. तो एक बार जब कीर्तन हो रहा था तो मेरे आँख से आंसू आ रहे थे अपने आप से, मैं इतना अब जो हो चुका था वहाँ पर. तो वहाँ से मैंने ठान लिया कि जब मैं जगन्नाथपुरी से जाऊँगा तो 16 माला ही करूँगा, 16 माला के नीचे एक भी माला नहीं करूँगा. तो तब से आज तक वो मैंने कंटिन्यू किया उससे. तो ये ट्रिप ले जाने से बहुत ज़्यादा ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन मेरा हुआ है. ऋषिकेश ट्रिप में बहुत ज़्यादा हुआ, उसके बाद जगन्नाथपुरी ट्रिप तो मेरा सबसे बेस्ट ट्रिप है अभी तक का, क्योंकि उससे मेरे को बहुत ज़्यादा रियलाइजेशन हुआ है. और जब जगन्नाथ टेम्पल में हम एंटर करते थे तो ऐसा लग रहा था कुछ अलग ही हवा चल रही है बाजार आने के बाद. इस वर्ड की नहीं हो सकती है, और कुछ अलग ही फीलिंग्स आती है जब आप दर्शन लेते हैं. तो और उसके बाद कंटिन्यू करने लगा. फिर हरिओम प्रभु को हमने थोड़ा लेकर के, हरिओम प्रभु को बताया कि आप भी आइए, सारा बच्चा है, हम लोग एंजॉय करेंगे, हम लोग घूमने भी चलेंगे बीच बीच में.
हरिओम कैसे बोला, तुम्हें सब भाग रहा था वो.
हरिओम को ऐसे ही बोला, थोड़ा सा लालच दिया.
नहीं नहीं वो तो तुम्हें है, तुमसे भाग रहा था, पकड़ा किसे तुम.
घूमने के लिए हम जा रहे थे.
हरिया इतना बदमाश तो है,
बोल रहा था कम पैसा लग रहा चल लेता. तो फिर लेकिन जब मैं अब देख पाता हूँ कि वो कितना प्रोग्रेस कर चुके हैं और मैं कहाँ हूँ, सचिव लोग कितना प्रोग्रेस कर चुके हैं, तो मेरे को ऐसा फील होता है कि मुझे और करना चाहिए. और बाकी सब लोग जो भी हैं जिन्होंने मेरी हेल्प की है, सब हैं, जैसे श्याम राय प्रभु हैं, सुनील प्रभु हैं और रवि प्रभु हैं, काफ़ी सारे लोग हैं जिन्होंने मेरे को काफ़ी ज़्यादा मोटिवेट किया है कि हाँ ईश्वर तो भक्ति, ईश्वर नेवर लीव भक्ति. और एक दिन जब मैं यहाँ से जा रहा था तो सर से मीटिंग हुई, तो सर ने मेरे को बोला, सर ने पर्सनली मेरे को बुलाया और सर ने बोला कि कहाँ मरने जा रहा है, कहाँ तुझे मारा कि आपको मैं कैसे छोड़ सकता हूँ, कितना मुश्किल है किसी एक इंसान को भक्त बनाना, मतलब कैसे छोड़ के जा सकता है. तो फिर मैंने सर ने बोला कि सर मैं कभी भक्ति को नहीं छोड़ूंगा. सर ने तो यहाँ तक बोल दिया था कि आई विल गिव यू 50,000 रुपीज़ फॉर मंथ, बट यू स्टे हियर यू डू सर. बट मेरा ही मैं ही थोड़ा घटिया टाइप का आदमी, तो मैंने इससे ज़्यादा कुछ सोचा नहीं. अच्छा लगा उसके बाद से मेरे को ऐसा लगता है कि यू शुड ऑलवेज बी इन द एसोसिएशन ऑफ द डिवोटी, देन योर भक्ति ऑलवेज प्रोटेक्टेड. और मेरे को ऐसा एसोसिएशन यहाँ मिला है. उससे पहले मुझे भक्ति का सिर्फ BHAKTI ही पता था. उसके बाद मैं यहाँ आया, जब आया तो मुझे थोड़ा और ज़्यादा पता लगा कि वाकई में रियल भक्ति है क्या. रियल भक्ति ये नहीं कि आप केवल अगरबत्ती को ऐसे घुमा दें या फिर धोती कुर्ता पहन ले तिलक माला लगा ले, ये रियल भक्ति नहीं है। रियल भक्ति इज टू प्लीज कृष्णा और टू प्लीज डेवोटी ऑफ द लॉर्ड। और वो हम केवल जब सेल्फलेस सर्विस करते हैं उससे ही हो पाता है, अदरवाइज नहीं हो पाता। तो मैं आप सबको फिर से सॉरी बोलना चाहता हूँ, अगर मैंने कुछ गलती किया तो आप मुझे प्लीज माफ कर दीजिएगा और मेरे लिए प्रार्थना करिए ताकि मेरी और बनते हैं।
तुम कब जा रहे हो मनीष? हैं? कल
शाम?
अभी हो ना तुम?
कल सुबह मिले।
नेहा एंड कृति आजा। बोलो बोलो बोलो। कुछ नहीं बोलो। अच्छा
कुछ तो बोलो। कुकीज दे दो। ये बोल दो। We should
aim for the rhinos. Piyush also started his presentation yesterday from this. Well, I love that quote of Shamsunda Prabhuji that we should aim for the rhinos. Kya hoga zyada zyada? Agar ganda mar gaya rhino ganda hota hai. Agar wo mar gaya to to aur hamara naam hoga nahi hoga to at least wo bolega rhino ke piche bhaga tha. So, main Prabhuji se ye seekh ke jaagi to mujhe lagta tha kahan hum itna aim kar sakte hain. Jobs karte hain, we are so scared to lose our job. I'm dead scared to lose my job. I mean, कितना हम लोगों को डर लगता है लाइफ में रिस्क लेने का. तो मुझे यहाँ पे कितना रिस्क मतलब लेके जैसे मैं आई एम सो इंस्पायर्ड विद द स्टोरीज. आई यूज टू रीड अबाउट द पीपल टाटा बिरला अंबानी के बारे में पढ़ते हैं. अंबानी अंबानी के बारे में पढ़ती रहती थी मैं. तो लोग कुछ भी नहीं है, ये तो हमारे सामने बैठे हुए हैं आज. और कभी कुछ शेयर भी नहीं करते हैं कि कितना प्रॉब्लम उनको फेस हुआ होगा इन द जस्ट गुरुकुल लैंड एंड ऑल. अंटिल नाउ आई डोंट नो दैट ही हैड गॉन थ्रू ऑल दीस थिंग्स. सो इंस्पायरिंग. एंड क्योंकि अगर भी होप की जो आप चाहते हो मैं वो करता हूँ. और हम लोग भी वही राइनोस को जॉब की एफेक्ट हम कर पाए और उसको एग्जीक्यूट भी कर पाए. एंड आई एम टेकिंग दिस थिंग कि बस हमें गुरु की इंस्ट्रक्शंस माननी है, बाकी सब चीज़ें अपने आप हो जाएंगी. लाइक ऑल ऑफ यू शेयर योर एक्सपीरियंसेस दैट एवरीथिंग विल फॉलो ऑटोमेटिकली. वी जस्ट हैव टू फॉलो द इंस्ट्रक्शंस ऑफ गुरु व्हिच ऑनेस्टली आई एम नॉट. बट आई रियली pray to all of you and pray to Prabhuji and Mataji and all the Vaishnavas there that please give me your blessings and please give me your mercy that I am able to execute the instructions of my Guru at least. I mean, kuch nahi to samajh to paun ki kya ho karte hain, wo dekh sakte hain humne. They are giving these services because they know us that we can do it. Only it's I think it's time to trust now. Thank you so much and thank you so much.
So let us give three times Hari Bol to Naya.
Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol.
And specifically all the gifts I am able to give you. Yeah, thus my special gratitude to Naya. Hare Krishna.
इतने से काफी जली भी हुई है तो जिसके पास जली भी आएगा तो प्लीज डोंट टेक्स मी.
फिर कृति. And I think we are done. I will give the rest of the gifts now to you quickly. But let's not forget these IIT Kanpur boys. They really worked very hard to host you here. And I think that Ashish Gupta, can you bring your group here?
Please, please.
Please,
please.
Sam, Sam, aaja
aaja. Actually, I forgot to tell you, we have a one guest, sir. So he has attended your program in Hyderabad. So
Acha, Balram.
No, no, Anuj.
Anuj.
So he attended your program in Hyderabad when you came. So now he's moved to Delhi. So
Acha,
just
Acha.
Because I'm coming here, so he wanted to.
I was wondering who is this boy. You are in Delhi.
I heard your lecture in Hyderabad.
No, no, you are now in Delhi.
Delhi.
So you came for this program?
Yeah.
Oh, very nice. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So let us welcome Anuj three times with Hari Bol.
Hari Bol! Hari Bol! Hari Bol!
Can you, Anuj, take a small gift?
Yeah.
Patiently hearing. And please, all IIT Kanpur boys, can you stand there so that at least everybody can say
Ankush.
Ada, Ada, sir.
Jitu, prefer.
आपके
पीछे
रुको तो अभी
सबका पूरे ग्रुप
प्लीज एवरीवन
कैसे लगता है मुझे पता
नहीं बोले रे.
पीछे कोई छोटा सा रह जाए।
अरे इधर आगे वाले आगे सामने आ जा महेश।
सामने वाले पीछे महेश।
हां ऐसे ही ओके अगेन थ्री टाइम्स हरि बोल
हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल।
लेट देम कंटिन्यू विद सच स्पिरिट ऑफ सर्विंग द डिवोटीज। दे ब्रिंग ऑल ऑफ द ऑल ऑफ यू एंड इट वाज अ नाइस फोरम फॉर एवरीवन टू नो ईच अदर बिकॉज़ एवरीबॉडी स्पोक फ्रॉम देयर हार्ट। इट्स गुड थिंग दैट हैपेंड। Thank you.
Thank you. One request, please.
And just, let me first finish the gift. People are wondering. Okay, first, our Himanshu. Himanshu. Come on, ये क्या? अरे आजा बेटे. Hare Krishna. Give three times Hari Bol to them. They are just.
Hari Bol. Hari Bol. Hari Bol.
Dios.
बच्चे के लिए.
Okay. हाँ. Dios के लिए three times Hari Bol.
Hari Bol. Hari Bol. Hari Bol.
राधाकांत हरिकेश कांत राधाकांत प्राची इधर आजा। प्राची कहाँ है? हाँ रघुनाथ।